Multiplayer! D-Class! Okay, Catalonia. Gonna go with the Nissan. Man, I'm still mad about that last race from previously, where I was in first place and then was running out of fuel on the second to last lap. That was fucked up.
In Catalunya's many fast off-camber turns, gravity will work against your traction, so be sure your car is pointed where you want it to exit before you get back on the throttle.
All right, all right, all right. Yeah, we went straight to qualifying. This is a decent length track. Is it gonna be raining during the race? I'm kind of getting that vibe. I wasn't paying attention to what the thing set up for them. As a front-wheel drive car, we do have a little bit of that understeer on that turn there. Not like that. fine, though. Obviously, I was testing the limits. During the race, I'll be a little more careful.
P4 after qualifying.
Miles. Let's see real quick. Oh, never mind. Can't see from the screen. Wanted to see what cars these other people are driving. We'll see in a minute here. Featured race, 6 laps. Fuel. 7 laps. Acura, Nissan, 1 Mazda. Escort, Eagle Talon. 94 Mazdas. Pretty good variety of cars here. On a Civic 97. I've seen the Honda Civic 97 at some top spots in some leaderboards. I think it's one of those cars, though, where they, like, put lots of horsepower in it, and it has, like, super terrible grip. So it's, like, in an actual race, that specific style tune is just really bad. Because it's just so hard to get around people. Unless there's a really long straight. Well, really, you need multiple straights if you're going for a high-speed car. We lost one of the guys that was ahead of us. Oh, it was the Mazda, too. I think I'll do pretty good here. Obviously, got a lot of people beat on lap times. But we'll see how the actual race goes. These top few people. Are causing troubles already. And that was a good turn for me. This guy's a break in my face. Go a little faster if this dude wasn't in my face here, but he is making things a little difficult. And he's probably gonna get away from me a little bit here, but we'll draft as long as we can. Room there. As far as this turn goes, however, okay, he was behind me. So if we can keep away from the guy behind us, we might be able to get close enough to the guy in front of us that we can start drafting. Yeah. That was not quite feeling like what I wanted, but we're still close. Lining a little too much in that corner there. Not ideal. Okay, barely stayed up on there. We got ourselves pretty close to this dude. Getting away. But we're closer than we used to be. I think we are able to break later than this guy, it seems. My hands are sweaty. I'm afraid my hands are gonna slip. take that corner too well. I let off the gas when we went a little off in the grass on the inside of the corner. So we can get on this straight as quickly as would be ideal. Oh my god! I'm looking for the opportunity to get in on him. He's really guarding that turn. Last lap.
Last lap. Let's go.
Really, ideally, would get in on him here. Oops. Close now. Okay, that wasn't ideal. Looks like we're gonna be stuck in second place, most likely. This car was definitely faster though. I had the best lap time, but I was drafting a lot, so. But yeah, at the end of the straight, the big straight, I should have maybe tried to properly get inside of him instead of I was trying to sort of just brake late, but yeah, I ended up ramming right into him. Oh well. Sometimes you just gotta be happy with second. Because, I mean, on average, second is better than usual for me. Somebody's still going? Apparently. Looks like we got some people freaking driving stock cars or something.
Well done. P2.
Oh man. All right. Next is Suzuka Circuit Short. I think this car is going to be good for that still, cuz this is my grip car, and then Suzuka Circuit's got the winding back and forth turns. You really want to have some grip for. Although what can happen is you get stuck behind somebody who has just a little bit less grip than you, and then you can't pass them on the turns, and then they have the advantage on the straight. And then you can run into problems, but hopefully that doesn't happen. Not looking good. Hit cancel. We'll see if it's an Alt-F4. Yep, Alt-F4. Classic. Featured multiplayer, E class, Silverstone. So I guess we missed out on the Suzuka. I'm not really sure. What car I want here. I feel like Silverstone has kind of like a lot of sweeping-ish turns. So, running this same car again should be... Okay, it's not the full version, but I don't think that particularly matters.
Late in the race, the outside of turns could be covered in rubber marbles from everyone's tires. So take that into account before attempting to pass slower traffic.
Rubber marbles. Never heard of that before. We have plenty of time to practice here. feel like 90% of the time I'm at Silverstone, it's like dark and or raining. So it's just so weird being able to actually see the track properly. Yeah, that's a little bit more than a 90 degree turn, so I gotta try to keep that in mind. Is fairly sharp. This is pretty much a non-turn. And then this turn is kind of medium. This is a sweeping turn here. I don't know if I really braked too early there, or what exactly. I'd push that guy off. Okay. It's a Miata behind me. That was not the turn. The fuck is going on there? I gotta pay more attention to that turn. It's just gonna be very, very important that I take that turn properly. By the little bumps. What kind of car is that? Oh, Miata. Classic. I still underestimated it. Alright, this guy is... Is this the same guy or a different guy? There's no way that same guy caught up to me, right? I mean, Miatas are OP, but I don't think they're that OP. Cars with this smokescreen bullshit before. But I don't know if it's like a bug or like some kind of hack or what exactly is going on there. Dude is going fast. Freaked out. Again, I was about to collide with that guy. He was ghosted. Which is why we just gone slow. Damn it! I don't think I want to go down to third. But I'm still fucking up that turn. Cool. Underestimating it. It's fine as long as I don't get a penalty, but when I go to qualify, I need to get myself a clean lap. And you get penalized for like a illegal pass if you pass somebody while off the track, so that wouldn't be ideal. That turn I fucked up. Be a clean lap. So if I can do that, qualifying, I'll be pretty happy with that. Obviously, it is not an ideal start on the grid. We'll have to see what the other people actually qualify at, though. I need to make that turn better also. Any turn before a significant straight is very important that you make that turn with the maximum exit speed. Like a couple people left. My tires are actually having trouble. So let's go qualify. And yeah. Just looking at it to make sure that it actually put on fresh tires for qualifying. That's something I didn't actually check before. Make sure that the game actually does that for you. I can probably take that first corner faster somehow, but I've just gotten used to going down to fourth gear for that. Corner. Without breaking at all, and obviously did not work out.
terrible at.
5 minutes till rate start.
Wait, what RPMs does this thing go to? About 7,200. Those red bumps, this is not good for the car.
One to go.
I started only in third gear for a second there, and that was actually not that bad. Little bit there, slowed us down when we didn't really want to, but at least we didn't go wide. Got people talking now.
Nicely done. Currently P4 after qualifying.
Hidden A to continue. And then, let's see. Where's the... this one. What we got? Let's see what we're up against. Austin 3065. I don't know if I've ever even seen that car before. So yeah, from the people who have qualified so far, there's a pretty big difference in times here. Seems like we're ahead of the average, but some of these remaining people could be pretty fast. 117. What? Does this thing just not update? I don't know why it's showing that guy at the end. Whatever. We'll see in a minute.
Seconds to race start.
Alright, let's get some fuel. Drag race, 6 laps. Got PTSD from that time I ran out of fuel. I think we're gonna go 8 laps. Those cars. What's a Honda Prelude? Really, really hate that they give you such a shitty view of the car. No one cares what the driver looks like. Bit of frame rate troubles, which really suck. And I did not take that turn well. But apparently a lot better than the people behind me. I went wide on the first turn, which...
Ooh. Ooh.
Oh, this guy is really... fucking up. He might be faster on the street. But... fucking up the turns. Fucked up, actually, that they don't give you a penalty for that in practice, and then they hit you with a fucking 0.9 second penalty during the race. A fucking huge penalty. That was a really odd collision. Guard the inside here. that. He might be faster than me on the straight. I'm not sure. But yeah. Obviously, I was on the inside of that dude, and I don't know if he realized it. But then, kind of the way I hit the bump. Was super not ideal. Choppy frame rate, just...
3 to go.
It's rough. Oops. I had to take that a little too fast, and that was not the plan. And we're kind of sliding. Oh my god, they're gonna give me a penalty, aren't they?
Total time penalty.
Fuck you. Oh my god. We're going wide. I decided to slow down there, so I think that avoided the penalty for me, but... I don't think there's any way for me to get far enough ahead of these guys that... I don't lose on the penalties I have. And this Miata just came out of nowhere. Might end up with penalties. Make sure I don't go too wide this time. Okay, this guy does have a slight penalty, but a lot less than mine. And then the guy behind me doesn't have any penalty. Oh no!
The final turn. Ouch. That hurts. But yeah, those first two cars, not even close. I might have been able to get third if I hadn't have got those stupid penalties, but... Definitely went wide a couple times. And also, things just got a little bit messy. Road America. When I was making this tune, I originally thought this would be the car for this, but it's actually the Lotus is better for this one. Basically, what is the other one? A Mercedes or something? Or was it an Aston Martin? I don't remember. But it's, so it's got higher top speed, but it doesn't actually reach top speed on this track. I did some testing on this specific track previously because it was intended to be good for this track, but it only gets up to about the same speed as the Lotus. And the Lotus has better grip and better acceleration, so... I don't know what the actual lap times on this track are. So not ideal that it's freaking looking like it's gonna rain. Or maybe it's just gonna be a foggy map. Have the transmission upgrades for this car, so that was really dumb of me. I don't have the transmission upgrades for this car, so it's
race starts in 5 minutes.
Can't really tweak it.
I should qualify. Still on? I thought it went off, but maybe not. I was trying to read the fucking signs to figure out when I'm turning. Because obviously, I needed to start qualifying. Didn't get the exact breakpoint figured out in practice. I think ideally, I take all the turns in third gear. We don't have a fifth gear. I think ideally I take all the turns in third gear, but probably gonna be some times during the race where I fuck up or have to avoid somebody or whatever and have to go to second gear. Should be a significantly better turn. And that's still a little bit ugly. Fucking did it again. I think I'm not taking that turn at quite the right angle. Definitely don't want to oversteer, but I think I'm taking that turn just a little slow. Improved our lap time, but time again here if I don't mess up the last couple turns. But I mean, the whole course comes down to four turns.
30 seconds.
Very important that you be your best. What the fuck is that? The fuck am- Wait. Is that whole section on track? Oh, we didn't have enough time anyways to finish that lap. Well, we might have if I was a little bit better, but I
like near the end of that last lap, I was like, wait a second, am I still qualifying? Fuel. Let's get enough fuel. And not too much fuel. Let's do that. Actually, let's just look at this list. Got ourselves a good variety of cars here. Not that many people in the lobby. I really think their lobby system is fucked up, though. Multiple ways. It is fucked up in multiple ways. But one thing that they could do, though, is start the lobbies smaller with, like, closer skill range. And then merge the lobbies. Merge lobbies when it becomes like race time. Or at least merge lobbies when entry is closed. Hopefully this guy will stop pushing me. So yeah, we accelerate a bit better than these other people in the lower gear, which is great. But these other guys had better lap times, so I think they're gonna generally beat me on the straights. Coming into that turn a little bit hot. Pretty happy with how I took that turn. Oh no, I'm too fast. Go down to second. I fucked that turn up. I was gonna go wide, I think, if I stayed in third, so I hit the brakes, went down to second. Draft a little bit here. Oh no. Oh there, buddy. Alright, so yeah, obviously, Frisk got farther away from us there, but could have been a lot worse. I would love to get the optimal race line here, but it's looking unlikely. Our
decided to hug the inside. And he slowed down to try to get in, do like an over-under kind of thing or whatever, but since I hugged the inside really well, he wasn't able to get in there. And it's telling me 3 laps of fuel remaining, which is a very bad sign. Because we currently have 3 laps to go. Fuel estimate was like 8 laps. So I think the estimate might just be like not intending you to go in the red line. Yep. Gotta be careful. That was fucking not ideal.
Total time penalty is about half a second.
Alright, I really need the fuel. Blah. If I don't drive in the red line, I'm just... shift out a third a little earlier, but one lap of fuel remaining, and I have a lap and a half to go. It's just not good. I think I have to pit. I don't think there's any way to not pit here. See how long this actually takes. Skip. Why is this 0.16 seconds? Wait, what? How does this work?
Last lap, let's go.
Did they like repair part of my car or some bullshit? The time estimate for the fuel width was not 2.5 seconds. All right, but yeah, note to future self. I need to go like 50% more than the fuel estimate for this fucking car. Fucking garbage. I'm gonna have to watch the VOD of that. Try to figure out why the pit stop. Took so long. Not that it really matters. In this case, as far as like it, two extra seconds would not have done anything for my placement, but. I really want to know, are they just like repairing cosmetic damage or something? Because when you have actual damage to the car, what map was this? I was trying to figure out from the picture. It looked like maybe it was a short version of, what's that called? Grand Oak? I think we're gonna go with the Lotus again. It said Laguna Seca there, but I don't think that's correct. Okay, now it says Hakone. Why the fuck did it say Laguna Seca for a second there? Is this the car that
running
I want?
Running counterclockwise here at Hakone is very fast through the first two sweeping turns with those sublime mountains around you. Keep your speed consistent hitting those inside apexes.
We're gonna go back to the Nissan. I don't wanna use this car somewhere also, but I just don't. I don't think it's really actually very good at anything. I think it's just, got higher top speed than some of these other cars, but it's just not useful because it's too slow to actually like get to its top speed. But yeah, so this car should be pretty good here because of the sweeping turns. I don't know if it'll be the Lotus. I think is still good here, but this car will definitely be able to take these sweeping turns faster. One of those turns where it would be really helpful to see the race line for what's considered like the optimal spot. I'm not gonna use the race line, but I'm just saying. I think the race line for turns like that is a pretty big advantage. Estimating my grip a bit here, but we need to get to qualifying. So we will see how we do. We're gonna get absolutely destroyed by like a Miata or something, but yeah, I could have gotten the gas a little harder there. Cutting into this turn too early, which is really not ideal. Okay. That was better. But obviously, the turn could be taken faster. Still have to clean that, right? Yeah. Car just does not turn when I'm on the gas, which is a bit frustrating.
Two more.
Okay. It's much better for that turn. But that turn completely botched. We're off track. Yeah. Thought we were gonna be good. And that's still not doing that turn properly whatsoever.
One more.
You definitely want to go out wide somewhere and then get angled so that you can start accelerating at the right time. Oh, shoot. We're not finishing this lap. So yeah, we're stuck with our other lap time. Am I gonna be able to... No. I was hoping I'd be able to at least get another shot at angling this turn right, but not gonna happen. All right. Let's see, we've got 6 laps. This car I'm pretty sure doesn't need as much extra fuel compared to the Lotus. What cars? Acura, Civic 97.
people didn't qualify. We'll see how it goes. Things can vary quite a bit. Oftentimes somebody destroys you in qualifying and then they just kind of suck in the race. For example, that guy had soft tires on, so that would have improved his qualifying time a bunch. But he's probably racing on mediums. I'm pretty sure softs won't last. So his actual lap times during the race are probably not going to be 1:15. I really don't know how good softs actually are. So I don't know if softs will save you like 2 seconds or how much time exactly. But you'll still have better. Like, medium race tires will still be better grip than my tires. Most likely. So, I mean, he doesn't have, like, super narrow tires or something. Place guy. If we can just draft behind him, that would be great. Like the whole race, basically. Obviously a bit faster than us on the straight here. Which is a bit disheartening considering he also has the fucking race tires. See, he angled that much better than I did. He's gonna be a lot faster on this straight now.
guy behind me is very close. Unless I can get the final turn better. Things are not looking good. Okay, he went out, I think, wider than you want to. Unfortunately, though, he is still drafting off me. We ain't shaking him that easily. But yeah, looks like we're definitely not catching first, unless he makes a big mistake. Pretty much aiming for second. Can't fucking see this guy, which really sucks. Chompy frame rate. That guy braked way late. He doesn't decide to come wide here and then run into me. All right. These guys are just a little more top-end speed than me. I really need to beat them on the corners if I'm gonna beat them. So far, it's not happening. We only got one lap to go. Like that was a decent turn, but
final lap.
Obviously,
not at all efficient to catch up to these guys. Do much besides that. Acura did manage 115s. Well, those other guys were both the same car on the Civic 97. The guy behind me had a better lap than me, but
great work. P4.
Like he got in some fights or something. What's next? Lime Rock Park. I either want to do the Nissan or the Lotus. If it'll freaking find me a lobby. Or it might be that situation where it closed or whatever. Not a good sign. Like we're canceling again. Probably Alt F4ing again. What a pain. Alrighty then. What do we got? We just fucking did Hakone. Why is there an... Oh, that's spec events. I was gonna say. Mugello. think the Nissan's good for Mugello. The Lotus also, though. Let's keep with the Nissan. We're kind of mainly just driving two cars, which is not super exciting. But D-Class is going to end.
It's an extremely fast layout, made up of sweeping turns that need to be taken at maximum speed, so stay on the race line as much as possible.
D-Class is going to end in... Wait, what day does it end? I was thinking it ends on Tuesdays, but actually I think it ends on like Thursdays. I'm trying to decide, do I go for more? Do I try to fix another D-Class tune-up or not? Oh, shit. Alright. So yeah. On this track. Very good to have some grip for these corners. We can take this turn properly and not sneeze this time. I don't know what gear I actually want to be in here, but let's try third. Nope. It ain't third. I did not get the practice I would have liked out of that last turn. And we're also going slower on this straight now because of it, so it is essentially ruining this lap time. I guess we can be in third, but we just need to not hold the gas down on that turn. We can only take that turn at like 60 miles per hour. Need to cut more on that turn. I kinda wish I'd rewind to be able to fucking test that turn. Ooh.
where I decided to try to brake was definitely too late. So yeah, obviously this lap's fucked up now. Oop, that was a cut. And we failed there. That one, we can like cut over the hump completely if you get it right. So, okay, I think that was a pretty good time to brake. I couldn't fully send it with the car right in front of me, but I feel like that worked out. Whoa there, buddy. Got an off track there. I'm also not cutting the next corner properly. So I braked about there to there. And it seems I need to probably go down to third. Maybe I can angle it just right and just coast and forth. Turned in too much, so I wanted to keep a clean lap, so I had to correct it, but not ideal a lot of times, and I didn't cut that properly. That one was pretty good though, and honestly that one's more important. Yeah, fourth is doable. I'm gonna go up to first on the leaderboard for now, but still plenty of time for people to pass me, and obviously that's not qualifying. And then, of course, there's also people who like smurf. And they like don't even try to get good practice or qualifying times. Okay, we slid a little bit there and lost some speed, so that sucked. Did improve our time a very slight bit. But we're probably gonna run into these guys here. Obviously, I took that turn very poorly, but it doesn't really matter when you have people right in front of you. Thought we were gonna be okay there. Do they say fucking no penalty now, and then during the race, that'll be a penalty? I don't think we got too much more we can do to improve our lap time. Unless we can either magically fucking take that first turn or the last turn. A lot better. Somehow I'm up on my splits. Oh, maybe I was drafting a bit. Oh, off track. And I braked late there, so I'm gonna go down to third gear. Not ideal. The good news is, so far, the leaderboard is looking nice and competitive. 110.280. I'm gonna actually... I can't change car. Why can't I change car? Why the fuck can't I change car? This has happened before. Maybe they disabled it? Like, I know for sure I have seen the ability to change car before, but maybe you can't after you start practicing. I feel like I've seen someone on Twitch, though, they run some laps in one car, and then they change car to a different car and just like compare their lap time to see which car is better, which is what I was going to do here. I was going to switch to the Lotus. But maybe they quit the lobby and come back with a different car, and I just don't remember that part. Ridiculous how much that fucking slows you down. So yeah, I guess we're stuck with this car, unless I wanted to actually quit and change the Lotus, but yeah. I don't know if the Lotus is better. Well, this will be definitely slower on these sweeping turns a bit, but this much better acceleration between these little sections. And on the straight, it'll be faster on the straight also. We'll enter the straight a little slower, but I think it'll make up for that fairly quickly. I really don't want to quit though. I like that the times in the lobby are pretty close. I think it'll be a pretty good competitive race. As long as we don't get somebody who's like pushing people off the track. Rolling. Oh, damn it! I wanted to ram him while he was flipping over. I think that would have been hilarious. Let's qualify. Pretty good. That's what I wanted. Can get a really nice first qualifying lap. That would be great. Turning for a second there. And I kinda oversteered a bit there. That should have been a bit faster. But overall, this is a pretty decent lap. Unless I botch it here.
5 minutes.
Oof. That was a really bad last turn.
Two more.
Alright, we got sub 110. So that's better than the any of the practice laps we had. Although some of the practice laps were hampered by the other drivers, so I could have probably had a better lap in practice. Alright, that was good. Where am I at? I'm a little bit behind, but if I take this last corner better, it might be a time improvement. I still didn't get a very good turn there. I came out of that a bit slower than I wanted to and couldn't get on the gas. Very quickly. So yeah, looks like our first qualifying lap's probably going to be our best. I thought I shifted to fourth already. Oh, we went wide. It's fine. Our split time was terrible. Okay, we didn't cut up the inside very well there. That was still a bad turn.
Nicely done. Currently P6 after qualifying.
All right, we'll just sit around for 2 minutes. Actually,
I'm gonna go get a snack. Go to the bathroom. Apparently it's raining IRL. I didn't get myself a snack yet, unfortunately. Alright. Let's say 10 laps. 10 laps of fuel. Fuck their fuel estimates. What do we got here? Besides people leaving. Opel Cadet.
Oh, great. Classic. Yeah, we'll see how this goes. It's looking like it's probably gonna be another fairly close race. Maybe one or two guys out front, and then me battling with like a few other people. Hard to say. Sometimes people get a good qualification time, but then they're like not consistent or whatever, and I just end up destroying them in the race. Only the second guy left. Got a pretty sleepy car. This guy's going a little slow, which is a little frustrating. He's a little faster than me on the streets, but slower on the curves. Buddy, give me room. That really sucked. That slowed down a bit, going on the grass. Oh! Shit. Is that gonna be a penalty? 0.3 seconds. I got off of that fucking off-track situation so fast, and they still gave me 0.3 seconds. Oh, that's a track cut.
Total time penalty is about a second.
That was more deserved. Although, I didn't track cut that at very high speed, so I feel like the 0.5 was still a bit harsh. Still close to this guy. Maybe we can get him to make a mistake or something. Feels like he's racing pretty conservatively though, and it's gonna be very hard to get him to make a mistake, and it's not really giving me any obvious opportunities to pass him.
He fucked up. Okay, we got him there, I guess. I think he's gonna pass me on the straight, though. At least he's not gonna be able to get away from me, though. But yeah, this penalty is, just really making this situation look like it's impossible for me to win against this guy. The people behind are also really close. Another track cut. Okay, they didn't give me a penalty for that one. I think that should have been a penalty, but they didn't give me one. So maybe that kind of balances out the karma. Are not beating this guy unless he makes a major mistake. That was weird. He let me get in there. Obviously with the penalty I lose, but he almost threw that. He took that really wide. And that almost cost him. Obviously, yeah, I fucked up with the penalties. If I didn't have the penalties, he would have been a lot more pressured to...
Well done. P4.
Drive more defensively and stuff. I didn't realize we had two people ahead of us, though. Is it just me, or is there a car missing? Okay. We got Homestead, Miami. Motherfucker. Fucking stupid ass game. Fucking lobby timeout bullshit. Homestead, Miami. Entry ends in 2 minutes. I didn't get a snack earlier. I want to grab a snack real quick. We're not going to have enough time for doing all the qualifying. I'll be back.
Final bend on Homestead. Stay far left for the transition on the banking to avoid unsettling the car.
Alright. Some nice cold yogurt since it's pretty warm. Alright. I think we'll get in hopefully 2 laps to qualify. Than what I was just driving, so gotta keep that in mind. Used this car on this track before, and it was pretty good, but There were still a couple cars that were like 2 seconds faster from that time. But whether or not those cars were in this lobby, I don't know. Okay, now we got somebody with a 141 up there. Oh, shit. Obviously, not the greatest job on that turn. It could have been worse. I wish I knew the best way to cut through these. Obviously, you can try to go over the curbs. But in a qualifying situation, like if I was doing practice, I wouldn't try it, but qualifying situation, really want to get the clean laps in. And since I don't have practice on it for the race, probably won't do it for the race either. Alright, could have been better as well, but not too shabby. Definitely better than the previous attempt. That was
30 seconds.
Pretty good cuts on there. So that was a good, that was a pretty good lap.
One to go.
By no means perfect, but. Oh, I keep. I tend to forget this car only has 4 gears. Drifting around the corners is not what I want. That's great for the hairpin turn, but apart from that, don't really want to do that. Alright, let's make sure we get plenty of fuel. This car. So what was it? I was running out of fuel on a 6-lap race when I told it 8 laps of fuel on the Road America. But I think that's largely just because on the big long straights, I'm in 4th gear up in the red zone on the fucking RPMs. We have 3 Mazdas right behind us. The first 2 guys are a couple seconds faster than me, so probably can't keep up with them. Maybe I can beat the Mazdas if they are bad. So I don't know why the car fucking tilts every time I rev the engine before the race starts. People are ramming me on the first turn. Good thing I fucking braked a bit early. Hopefully this Mazda isn't gonna ram me. Hold him for the draft. My bad.
Total time penalty is about half a second.
Ooh. Got a penalty for that? That sucks. Not like I fucked him up. I could have done that better. They went wide there. Into first for now. And I'm out of first for now. obviously, I did not take that turn well whatsoever, but apparently these guys are still behind me. Really need to make sure I brake earlier for that fucking hairpin. I gotta keep an eye on the mirror where these guys are at. Choppy frame rate, classic. I overbraked for that, unfortunate. God damn it. Thought I could squeeze in there, and then I was out in the dirt, and more people passed me because of that. The fuck did I end up facing the right way? That was a miracle. Oh no. They gave me a penalty for that, too. That was almost beautiful, and then I kept spinning a little too much. Yeah. Breaking a little too early for that again, and it's hurting my time. I wish I was close enough to draft. In front of me has a significant penalty, more than me. But I don't know if I can get close enough.
Last lap.
The frame rate's not smooth. No, don't oversteer. At least not there. Feels like they're so close, but I'm still sliding. Why the fuck am I sliding? You guys took each other out, I guess. That's good for me. He hit the dirt a little there, which is not ideal, but he's still too far ahead of me. And I'm not taking that quite right. So that'll be it. Alright. They go off track again. They ended up farther behind me than I thought they were. First place guy had even more penalties, but his car was just significantly faster. Well, maybe not. His best lap was a dirty lap, so it's possible he got penalties during that and it wasn't actually that much faster. But yeah, I was in first for a little bit, and then made a couple mistakes and then got clobbered.
Good work out there. P3.
But I mean, Why do they give you that close of a zoom in on the first place car? Alright. Fucking VIR. So. I've previously raced the Lotus here. I feel like it's not that great, but... Oh shit, practice ends in 26 minutes? I don't want to be practicing here for 26 fucking minutes.
The quicker you can get back on the gas, 100%.
Does that mean we like just missed the better chance a different one? Finishing up
front. Podium finish. Let's go.
All right. See, we can select car here. I think I'm just gonna be done for now. That was a good time for me to take a break and might try to redo that all-wheel drive car that we have, and maybe another one also. So this car feels obsolete, basically, in my D-class lineup. Yeah, so I think I'm gonna change that one up, or I might do something with a different D-class car. Give myself more options to race with in the future.